We've seen a lot of Hotel Mario memes, even though the game itself is still horrible as it seems. But where are those creative, well-made mashups, which all of us can rely? Lucky there's a mashup guy! He's been making covers, he's a Rosalina lover. There'll be lots of things that'll make us laugh and cry. He's a mash-up guy!
Well, here we go. My second rant on my channel. So, what happened last time? Batman and Robin, an absolute disgrace to the Batman film series. And this time, it's going to be on a show a lot of people love. A show that was amazing, charming, and funny, but now it is becoming more insufferable. And that is... Family Guy. Okay, before you grab your torches and pitchforks and think I'm the most hateful person on the planet, or the entire galaxy, but please just hear me out. Family Guy is now becoming a lot more sadistic and just doesn't know when to quit as the show goes on. And I know some of you thinking, Dogzine Dog 6, why did you use the Family Guy theme song for your new intro? Because Family Guy nowadays is only good for nostalgia by looking at past episodes and using clips during videos. When the show first came out, during the first four seasons, it was endearing, charming, and funny, and the characters were relatable, as well as some really amazing moments, especially in season 4. AKA my favorite season of the show. But nowadays, we get endless torture! Cutaway gags used way too often instead of, you know, storytelling, and many pitiful attempts at making jokes solely for cheap laughs, and they fail at it! This is one of those shows that try to step on the world because it's so edgy and cool, but I've got news for you, it's not! So, let's get to it! Why Modern Family Guy is a cartoon disgrace! Do I really need to say what's gone horribly wrong, especially the fact that the characters have been flanderized nowadays? Peter is an uncaring sociopath. Lois is a drug addict whore. Chris is just Seth Green doing whatever the episode calls for. Meg gets universally hated for no reason. Stewie is a sadistic homosexual deviant. Brian is a liberal douche. Quagmire is a sex-crazed maniac and a bigger douche than Brian. Cleveland is Black Peter, and Joe is used for crippled jokes and making fun of the mentally disabled. Before I unleash my true rage, do you know the few episodes which I find remotely amazing, at least in the modern era? Road to the Multiverse, and then there were fewer. Mr. and Mrs. Stewie, Brian's Play, Meg Stinks, The Simpsons Guy, Peter Normal Activity, a lot going on upstairs, Big Trouble in Little Quahog, and also Back to the Pilot. But everywhere else, you just wonder why I still watch Family Guy. Especially when I hear recurring quotes like that time when, or remember back in, when they set up a cutaway gag every time. Okay, now it's time to really get started to yell and rage at a truly once great show has now become one of the worst shows ever, if not the worst. The first four seasons were spectacular, especially season 4. Seasons 5 and 6 weren't that good, but still had some good episodes like Stewie Loves Lois, Meet the Quagmires, and the Stewie Kills Lois / Lois Kills Stewie 2-parter, aka what should have been the last episode of season 6. But starting from season 7, it's becoming a lot more mean than before, and we'll get to why. You people better beware, because I'm about to say some super harsh things about Family Guy nowadays. Time to tackle the 10 biggest problems with the show. Before my rage truly begins, Stewie and Meg have not changed whatsoever. Besides, these two are my favorite characters in the whole show. I love Stewie, as he still had some amazing moments, including the Road 2 series, and as for Meg, who is played by Mila Kunis, she's the punching bag of the show, which unfortunately I'll cover later on. I mean, what do you expect? Calling her ugly is just so mean! She's cute, loving, and needs a kiss or a hug! And as for the others, two of them I'll cover on them more, as they're the worst offenders of character flanderization. Lois was a beautiful and sweet mother who played piano music beautifully and cared for her family. Nowadays, she's the most intolerable and annoying female lead in any cartoon! A sex addict and a bitch to her kids, and has a god-awful laugh and high-pitched voice. In one episode of season 7, she gives Meg pills and a suicide book to help kill herself. Don't believe me? Here, listen.
Okay, look, Meg, I've been at this for 45 minutes. I don't know what else I can say. Here's a Sylvia Plath book and a bottle of Ambien. I'm gonna look the other way and whatever happens, happens.
Oh, and I think Meg said it best.
Is this coming from my role model mother? The shoplifter, the drug addict, the porn star, the whore who let Gene Simmons and Bill Clinton go to town on her? My point is that with all the irresponsible, reckless, idiotic behavior in your past, that somehow, somehow you have the nerve, the arrogance to consistently and ruthlessly point out my shortcomings.
Exactly! She's a slut, a bitch, a bad mom, a bad wife, drug addict, shoplifter, her annoying voice that makes your ears bleed, a cheater, and she's fucking heartless! So many people hate her, especially for her voice. Making someone's ears bleed is not funny! Talk about annoying and loud! Peter and Lois should get a divorce. As for Chris, he just does what the plot tells him to, and he just acts like an asshole. Most of the side characters need to die a horrible death. Bonnie is a discriminating little shit who has a real problem with crippled people. Seriously, why the hell isn't she in prison? Who wasn't like that before? Carter, well, he's been getting too much attention these days for no reason. And he acts just as bad as Peter. And I have a very big hatred for Quagmire. Back in the older seasons, Quagmire is one of my top three favorite characters in the show. He's a likable pervert and says quotes like, "Heh heh, alright." And how can we not forget his infamous,
"Oh, giggity 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 goo."
Who else but Quagmire?
He's Quagmire.
Let's have sex.
Yep, you guessed it, giggity.
But now, he's a sex-crazed maniac who lusts for women and dates them for their bodies and their personalities and has a huge hatred for Brian.
This is official. Quagmire is Brian's nemesis. And Cleveland, as I previously stated, is Black Peter. There's other characters that I don't like that much, like Consuela, who got overused way too much. The only side character I like is Bruce, but everyone else, forget it!
Oh, and Joe's becoming a lot more worthless.
Shut the fuck up!
Here's when things start to get really lazy! Using live-action footage for no reason whatsoever is one of them. Some examples include Conway Twitty and that music video of Dancing in the Street. Even though I liked the song, but the music video was unneeded.
That happened, and we all let it happen.
It's ridiculous how Family Guy can just slap a realistic poster on a lunchbox that Peter got for Christmas. Or how about a full-sized cardboard cutout of a real-life female? For fuck's sake, draw the fucking characters! Stock footage or live-action footage does not match with Family Guy. If this was South Park or SpongeBob, I could easily understand, since it works much better in those shows. Like modern SpongeBob, Family Guy writers just don't bother writing something original. Most plots have a subplot about some stupid relationship. Mainly Brian. That just end in a breakup at the end. Who the fuck cares? There's an episode where Brian dates an older woman, an atheist, a rich lady. The list goes on way too long. Then there's Stewie and Brian doing some stupid time travel bullshit and something fishy goes on. A lot of times too, Peter is doing something incredibly stupid at the beginning of the episode and it ends after halfway, leading to the other plot. Wow! That's fucking original! Not even Sherlock Holmes could distinguish the differences. Oh wait, anyone can easily do that! We're not idiots! This is 90% of episodes from Family Guy since maybe around 2009, I think. The Simpsons had wonderful plots all the way up to even past season 11. And then they still get it right sometimes. Bad episodes in that show, for some reason, to me, are isolated incidents. Another thing, and I consider this an extension to this complaint, is ratings traps. Examples? The episode Long John Peter from season 6. It promised a fun adventure of Peter as a pirate. What's that? The episode features Peter as a pirate and his crew? What's that? The trailer shows only pirate action? What's that? The whole thing was only 4 minutes? Well, we got you there, bitch! For fuck's sake, why? That's just pathetic in my book. The Simpsons guy had a really good concept, but instead of focusing on all of the Simpsons and Griffins, they just focus on Homer and Peter. The worst example, though, is Life of Brian and Christmas Guy from season 12. Season 12 promised a character would be killed off. Life of Brian, Brian is killed. Christmas Guy, they bring him back. Regardless of petitions or whatever, it was a setup the whole time. The point is, if you're going to have a plot about something cool, I expect it to last the entire episode. If not, then just quit, please. The definition of filler is shoving some unimportant shit into the episode and jacking up the runtime because of likely plain laziness. Family Guy is very notorious for this. Namely, the pacing. Old Family Guy's pacing wasn't too quick and wasn't too slow. Take a look at this scene when Peter makes dad noises. This really isn't that funny because of how slow and boring and long it can get. It all started with a god-awful joke where Stewie calls for Lois for 30 seconds straight, and then it grew to bad jokes like Cool Whip.
Cool Whip? You're saying it weird. Why are you putting so much emphasis on the H?
And the notorious smashing the bench with a crane because we can't write good jokes sequences. It's either that or long sequences of dialogue that just go on and on and on. Also, Mr. Booze, which was too long. That's another thing. Some of the songs are just too damn long nowadays. We fucking get it, Seth. You can sing. Congratulations. Nobody gives a fuck. The more infamous ones are the recent chicken fight sequences in No Chris Left Behind and in The Simpsons Guy, which is just Homer and Peter beating each other up for 7 whole minutes with boring jokes. There is no need for shit like this. Another problem is the amount of reused awful jokes. Remember that knee joke from the episode Wasted Talent? Yeah, that was funny for the first time, but the writers just need to shove that into the season 7 episode Foxy Lady. What's the difference? Lois trips on her chest and grabs her boob. Lame! Then there's these 5-second jingles they overuse. You know, like
Family Guy, we've been on for years.
Italians are not Jews.
Or
Japan, they kill things that we like.
With words on the screen? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about! Stop doing that! The writers are either too lazy or not even talented enough to create a coherent plot to fill in the time gap of 30 minutes. By this, I mean that the majority show is covered with those lame cutaway gags.
Back in seasons 1 through 4, they were kind of charming and little breaks from the plot that had their side of humour. But hey, those would be considered filler as well, but back then, they didn't use as much as they do in the later seasons.
It's almost like every 5 minutes, there'll be a cutaway gag there that doesn't even move the plot, make any sense, or is even all that funny. They are either gross, dull, or just plain disturbing in some scenes, like the time they had to show Peter's hairless twin in the episode Fresh Air, or Peter showing off his giant ass through Daisy Dukes in The Simpsons Guy. How interesting, because nowadays, these cutaways will not go away! They keep happening and are mostly unfunny to begin with. And there's also jokes we've seen before, especially if they're taken from someone else!
Oh, and the worst cutaway gag of all time? Was in the episode Quagmire's Mom from season 13, when they showed us a still image for about a minute while they waited for a song to start. Okay, that's not funny. What's the point of that? Okay, that's enough now, and for fuck's sake, it's still going!
Plus they're apart! That just get too fucking old! Like the chicken fight scenes. How many times is that chicken going to come back from death and fight Peter to the finish only for him to win at the end, and the chicken giving that menacing stare to the camera? It is proof that these writers don't know how to write a plot anymore,
and either throw in some filler that's either going to bore you or shock the living shit out of you, just to get some kind of reaction.
Oh, speaking of which...
I've already mentioned the hairless twin, but how about the time Peter was tricked into getting a free hat in that season 8 episode where he understood the instructions and suddenly his head gets squished by two large logs? It's bad enough seeing the blood spatter, but do we have to deal with seeing what he looked like afterwards? Just no! Also, sometimes they like to show too much detail on a character's face, like the Ricky Dennis character, for example.
Correction, it's Rocky Dennis.
Or that one Fox News anchor woman that was canned because of the high-def televisions. I'd rather watch Krusty the Clown in HD from The Simpsons. Seriously, guys, you better get better animation, and all you want to do is shock us or gross us out! What the fuck?!
Many episodes these days have some ultra-violent moments that are just too unbearable to watch, like Peter disemboweling a giant whale and Santa's workshop being run by monster-like elves and rabid reindeer. It's like Itchy and Scratchy or Tom and Jerry, but with heavy blood and cringeworthy sequences.
In almost every episode, there's at least one scene of someone getting impaled, beheaded, teeth knocked out, shot to death, or even have a broken bone sticking out of them. Oh, and one of the worst jokes in any show I've heard.
Hey, Lois, if I was going to kill myself, do I slit my wrists this way or this way?
Sideways for attention, long way for results.
Way to go, Family Guy! You just took the award of worst joke ever made on a show!
In some episodes, Family Guy tackles serious topics like domestic violence. Namely, Horton hears domestic violence and doesn't call 911? Really? And make jokes out of it. It's just depressing. I'd fire a writer if I ever saw a joke like this as a concept.
Oh, get ready for the top 5.
Now we're getting to the characters who everyone has been calling the worst. Even Phantom Strider and Mr. Enter. Back then, Brian used to be the voice of reason, always comforting everyone, while also having an interest in human women. But his friendship with Stewie is the biggest highlight, since we see them bonding a lot throughout the show.
But all his good characteristics have come to an end, in my opinion. Since around season 8 or season 9, when he finally starts a writing career, since then, he becomes so arrogant that it's so hard to even forgive him. He even fires Stewie because he gets some arrangements mixed up and doesn't even apologize properly for it. As a matter of fact, he has become a bit of an awful friend to Stewie since then. Or at least more awful. When Stewie gets an abusive teacher, Brian doesn't report her right away because he's so attracted to her. But only then does he realize that she already has a boyfriend, that he finally reports her. Another worst example is when he gives Stewie herpes without any remorse for it. He even does it to Chris without informing him that he has herpes. And his apology isn't even good enough because he does it too late after giving an infant a disease. Then there's his rivalry with Quagmire. It's nothing special, but once, when he loses his teeth, he pretends to be sorry for Quagmire just to give way for some explosive countdown or something. Oh yeah, and there's also the episode where he's being a bad father to his son Dylan. He uses Dylan's acting career to his advantage just so that he can go ahead with his writing career. And when he is feeling remorseful for his son, because Dylan had rightfully disowned him, he tries to make it up for him when he doesn't deserve to. Even uses Stewie to apologize for him. Changing someone's personality is not okay! Brian is therefore the worst fictional dog, in my opinion. I'm talking about new Brian, not old Brian. He should have stayed dead after the episode Life of Brian. At least Vinny was much better, although some might argue with me, he's just another Italian stereotype. I know Mr. Enter calls him the worst character of Family Guy, but there is one character I loathe even more. Who is it? We'll find out later on.
Oh my God!
Fuckface!
Family Guy first hit the airwaves in 1999. The series is now in its 20th season. But there's no end in sight. The show garnered quite a reputation over the years. The series is both brilliant and controversial. Of course, there's been a decline in the quality after several seasons. The series may have overstayed its welcome. Why? Because the writers on the show are actually self-aware of their problems. They don't want to fix the show. No! They refuse to fucking fix it! I've seen shit on this show that mocks people, including ex-Family Guy fans myself. Oh, and then there's this.
Family Guy, we've been on for years.
Hey, I've got a complaint for you, Seth. Fuck you!
Oh my gosh, we're really at the top three now.
This next one you're about to see is a character you really love, but now you hate him. The worst offender of character flanderization is the fat bastard himself, Peter Griffin. Finally, I get to talk about my hated Family Guy character of all time. He has the same situation as Brian, where he was one of the most lovable characters of all time. He was that father figure who had really dumb ideas, but he was also responsible, lighthearted, had a good moral compass with the help of Brian, and he was not only one of the best father figures out there. I want any father out there right now who has seen seasons 1-4. And raise your hand if you thought you could actually relate to Peter in any way. That's what used to be so great about Peter. He was a very relatable and three-dimensional character and a loving husband and father. But now...
He is the most despicable cartoon character I've ever seen! He commits so many evil and unforgivable things that it's just downright mean!
He has become a psychopath who does loads of crimes that he doesn't even get arrested for!
He admits that he beat up his kids as infants, doesn't like them to be in his presence, gives his son Stewie steroids, abuses his daughter Meg, both physically and mentally, tries to marry his other son Chris when it's
incest,
makes fun of Lois, hurts his friends, joins forces with terrorists, attacks and murders innocent people and animals, and robs from innocent businesses.
I just can't believe he hasn't been sent to jail yet. Because he doesn't deserve to be the main character anymore.
He might as well be the antagonist. Hell, he even irritates me every time he pops up on screen.
Also, how about the fact that he never tries to improve himself as a father or human being? All he does is get drunk and abuse Meg. He will also harm his family, his friends, and even random strangers. Peter always gets away with everything. He's unsympathetic, he's unreliable, and whenever the writers try to make you feel sorry for him, it fails because of how unlikable he is. Any villainous act he does is something no one with a brain would ever do. They just do stuff like this because it's funny. None of the stuff makes you laugh or chortle. It just makes you want to yell at him to shut up.
Which is a real shame because Peter used to make me laugh in the older seasons, but now he's not really that funny.
I get that Peter had jerky moments in the older seasons, but he was still kept likable. Now he does whatever reckless thing he wants and treats everyone else like utter shit and doesn't even suffer consequences when he wrongs others.
Writers, if you try to make your main character that hateable and stupid in an unfunny way, then that's a really big problem. I even found a song to describe how heartless and immature Peter truly is.
You're a mean one, Mr. Griffin. You really are despicable. You are nothing but a fat and ungrateful imbecile, Mr. Griffin. What you're doing is not only evil, but unforgivable. You're a monster, Mr. Griffin. A horrible father and husband you've become. Your callousness and stupidity, they cannot escape from, Mr. Griffin. Consider yourself the worst father of any cartoon, you rebel scum. You're a vile one, Mr. Griffin. Your show does not want to end. You shot Quagmire in the arm because you're such a bad friend, Mr. Griffin. You really lost your charm and likability, but would they watch your show again? I wouldn't recommend. You're a liar, Mr. Griffin. Your existence makes me mad. You hate being around your kids and your marriage is really bad, Mr. Griffin.
There is a father figure who's better than you.
There are three words that are known for, and I quote...
Seven...
Grand... Dad... Flintstones?
You're a scumbag, Mr. Griffin. You always get off scot-free. Your heartless shenanigans aggravate me, Mr. Griffin.
My friends and I on Discord don't approve of your behavior, not even my gal Rosalina. But there is one guy who hates Modern Family Guy and Batman and Robin, King Ollie.
You're an abuser, Mr. Griffin, you're rude, arrogant, reckless, and lazy.
Not funny, didn't laugh, I'd rather listen to.
Hi, I'm Daisy.
Mr. Griffin.
You are causing a lot more harm and misery to your family and friends. Not only you've lost your mind, but
you've really gone crazy.
I hate you all so much! And give me that! Stop! Stop! Son of a bitch!
Fuck you!
Modern pedia!
He's a bully! That's who he is! He's a domineering, sadistic, intolerable, irritating, annoying, self-centered, torture-creating, anger-producing, bigoted, hateful, uncaring, heartless, lying, cheating, stealing, disobedient, and immature man-child! Peter Griffin is one of the biggest reasons why we hate Family Guy now. In the world of classic Family Guy, I love Peter to no end. But in the world of modern Family Guy, I fucking despise him! Fuck! This trend needs to stop now. For fuck's sake, stop this trend. It's getting old. Put this to an end. Typically, Meg wasn't really bashed until season 5, where it just got out of hand. Sure, in season 4, Meg was picked on a bit, but when Peter sold her, it was as a last resort. And Peter popping a melon on her was a prank. Also, when they forgot Meg in Jungle Love, was just Peter not being the brightest person out there. And when Peter yelled that Meg sucks in my favorite episode, PTV, he was just frustrated that he didn't get to watch the Emmys. In many of the newer episodes, Meg is seen trying to kill herself, or the family talks down on her for no fucking reason. Again, in season 4, none of those were what I call Meg bashing, since they're more of just little pranks or mistakes made by her or other characters. What the fuck did Meg Griffin do to deserve all of this abuse? She's just a common every girl who acts nicer, but she gets shat on just for her looks alone. In 2 episodes, Peter has taken his daughter's head, shoved it in his ass, and farted on it. In Jungle Love, when Meg is on the phone with the rest of the family, they all desperately try to avoid her. In Peter's daughter, she is so hated by Peter in one of the cutaways, he actually fucking shoots her with a gun. In Petergeist, we're even told if they could only save 2 of the family, Peter and Lois would leave Meg behind to die. Hell, in 8 Simple Rules for Buying My Teenage Daughter, he sold his daughter out for slave labor to the Goldmans to pay off a tab he couldn't pay. What the fuck is wrong with this family and their constant abuse towards her? What were these writers thinking? Not sure why they resorted to this, but again, Meg is one of my favorite characters on the show. She's cute, loving, and needs a kiss or a hug. Make this trend stop, or I'll rip your fucking heart out! Before we get to number 1, let's do a quick recap. Number 10, rewriting personalities is not okay. Number 9,
that happened, and we all let it happen.
Number 8, reusing plots from past episodes. Number 7,
boring.
Number 6,
bro, you just get cringe.
Number 5, liberal douchebag. Number 4, end already. Number 3,
fuck off.
And number 2,
shut up, Meg.
I am not joking when I say this.
This is by fucking far the meanest show in the entire galaxy! Not only is everyone in Quahog a dick a lot of the time,
they get off scot-free for their evil wrongdoings, like in the episode Family Guy, when
Peter gets haunted by his dad. He takes a rifle and shoots his wife! just because she is Jewish and calls it a warning shot, then shoots at Mort, and Mort says that's how people say hello to him. Bring us back to Brian the Closer. When Quagmire actually paid for new teeth for Brian instead of the Griffins, he actually screws Quagmire out of his hand-earned money into buying a rundown condo, and it was the same teeth that gave Brian the realty job. Fucking asshole! I have already mentioned the constant abuse towards Meg, Lewis letting her commit suicide and so on. But also Brian telling Meg that there is no God just because she looks ugly. Fucking hell! There's also the old man in the big sea from season 11.
One of the worst endings ever.
He found the cure for cancer, and instead of keeping his promise of releasing it to the public, he lies, and yet the Griffin family are laughing cheerfully. Flying fuckballs!
By far the
meanest episode to exist is Screams of Silence, especially since the previous episode, Seahorse Seashell Party, says we should stay in abusive relationships, and then they bring this nightmare in where we have to deal with Brenda, who is Quagmire's sister, being beaten up constantly by her abusive boyfriend. The only other thing I have to say about this is that the boyfriend is one of those bland as fuck bully types with a huge anger issue. And the only form of catharsis we get is Jeff getting run over by Quagmire. This wouldn't be such a shitty episode if Seahorse Seashell Party didn't come before this. Let's also remember all the times that this show has basically made fun of Joe for being handicapped and decided to not only destroy his reputation as a hero cop, but also decided to throw in some jokes that Joe wants to commit suicide because of his handicap. Also, the whole relationship between Bonnie and Joe has turned into one of the worst couples in animation history, if not in general. It's actually just as bad as Peter and Lois and Edward and Bella from Twilight. Bonnie feels that she can't stand to live in a relation with Joe because he's handicapped. Then Joe decided to cheat on Bonnie because of all the crap she puts him through, and then he got scolded for it. Really, Bonnie? You have no fucking right to judge. You were going to have an affair and leave Joe in the first place before all that, you fucking bitch. Also, Bonnie likes to treat her own son Kevin like crap as well. In one episode where Joe decided to not hang himself, Bonnie left the house and burned it to the ground. Please tell me that Kevin and her baby aren't burned alive. Seriously, what is it with this show in treating Joe like shit now just because he's a handicapped person? Oh, and let's not forget the amount of racism, sexism, politics, and religion bashing in this show. Most of them are blunt as an atomic bomb, and others don't even make sense. I'm sure you're enjoying your Klansman uniform, Seth. These mean tones fit well at home with Breaking Bad and The Walking Dead, not a fucking light-hearted animated sitcom like Family Guy. This is supposed to be funny and charming, not fucking cruel. This makes the show come off as not only jarring, but also a bit scary. One more thing, it doesn't even feel like the show is trying to satirize anything or create any interesting characters. It just feels like it's shoving cruelty down your throat because Seth or any of his writers think it's funny. The reason for that is because this show has a level of arrogance to it. It was canned and revived twice, and they believe that nothing can kill the show, no matter how bad they make it. Let's face it, this show has been on
for way too long. It needs to be cancelled for real. I'm done with this atrocity. Do you hear me? Done. Seth, cancel your show now. You're not cool or edgy or unique or any of that shit. No, it's pathetic. It's pretentious. Morty Family Guy is everything I loathe in a cartoon. I hate it. I hate it.
Ugh. Thank you, Rosalina. You are one dynamite gal. What was I doing again after my head exploded? Oh yes! Sorry, guys. Family Guy has gotten a lot worse than before. It's becoming a lot more horrifying, sickening, and a lot more cruel. They are clearly running out of story ideas, and I feel like they should just give up and stop before things get way more hectic. There is no reason to watch it, my friends. It's time to part ways with Family Guy and make other shows. Maybe make spin-offs of these characters. Sure, they may not hold a candle to the first four seasons, but at least it would be interesting to see what they'd be like and if they actually have good writing, unlike the Cleveland show. Then they'd be great shows. Family Guy nowadays is only good for nostalgia by looking at past episodes and using clips doing videos. But then again, that's the only usefulness it had to offer. But I am still not even done. I only recommend the first four seasons and maybe five and six, but everything else, it is nasty, cruel, mean, and unfunny offensive garbage, and I never want to watch it again. Now for the final verdict. The jury has found Seth MacFarlane and his writers guilty for making a show that was once funny and charming, but now, with bad writing, cringeworthy visuals, lack of good comedy, constant use of ratings traps, character derailment, contempt towards its audience, and being a negative influence on adult animation in general. Now, since Batman and Robin has been folded into a crane by King Ollie, I sentence Modern Family Guy to be murdered by scissors! Murder them!
Like, what if it wasn't called, like, what if it was called Boppo? Huh? Oh, I got a little Boppo. Oh, that's cute. Ah!
Once again, I cut a worthless cartoon.
He has no style. He has no grace. This car is a money race. Put your hands together. If you wanna clap, help me get you through. This monkey rap, he's the leader of the bunch, and you know him well. And he's finally back to cut some tail. He's one hell of